Laudetur Jesus Christus, praised be Jesus Christ. Greetings and welcome to all of you from wherever you are joining us. We are coming to you live from St. Peter's Square. As you can see on your screens, those who are following us on television, crowds have gathered here at St. Peter's Square to welcome the Holy Father and to greet the Holy Father, but also to pray with the Holy Father. So we join this enthusiastic crowd and we gather on this beautiful morning here in Rome. It's a bit cold, but it's beautiful. As you can see, the sky is completely blue. Not a single cloud is seen on the sky. So we meet for a weekly appointment with our Holy Father, Pope Francis. At 12 noon, Pope Francis will recite the Angelus from the window of the Apostolic Palace, as he usually does. The window is already prepared, as you can see on your screens. We have just concluded a beautiful Eucharistic celebration presided over by Pope Francis this morning on the occasion of the Sunday of the Word of God on this, the third Sunday in Ordinary Time. On behalf of Vatican News, I welcome all of you who are joining us for this Angelus prayer from all over around the world. Welcome to all of you joining us through various Vatican media channels, Vatican Audio Live Event app or the Radio Vaticana app, the Vatican News web portal or Vatican News English YouTube channel or our Facebook live feed. We welcome those of you joining us through television, Catholic TV, Catholic Faith Network, Shalom World Television Networks USA, EWTN TV, Salt and Light TV, Shalom TV India, at Madarshan TV India, UCTV, Uganda Catholic TV. But also we welcome all of you joining us through radio stations, listeners from Radio Maria England, Luminous Radio India. We also greet and welcome those who are tuning in through other local or diocesan radio broadcasts and those picking up the shortwave transmission. A warm welcome to those of you joining us through our American Sign Language broadcast. And to all of you joining us through other internet sites and digital platforms throughout the world, welcome to you all. It's a great joy to have you with us as we gather in communion for a moment of prayer with our Holy Father, Pope Francis. On behalf of Vatican Media, my name is Bonga Majola, and it is my pleasure to provide the English language translation and commentary for the Angelus prayer this afternoon. This Sunday, January 21st, we celebrate for the fifth time the Sunday of the Word of God. And this year's theme is taken from the letter of St. John, chapter 8, verse 31. Remain in my word. We know that the Sunday of the Word of God is a pastoral initiative of the new evangelization with the aim of reviving the responsibility that believers have in knowing sacred scripture and keeping it alive through a work of permanent transmission and understanding, capable of giving meaning to the life of the church in the different conditions in which it finds itself. The Sunday of the Word of God was instituted by Pope Francis with the motu proprio Aperuit Illis on 30 September 2019. And on the third Sunday of Ordinary Time, it's dedicated to the celebration and reflection and dissemination of the Word of God. And the Holy Father is ready, so we welcome him and we hear his message today and his catechesis today.
Cari fratelli e sorelle, buongiorno.
Dear brothers and sisters, buongiorno.
La vocazione dei primi discepoli, quella di chiamare altri a unirsi.
The Gospel today recounts the vocation of the first disciples. Calling others to join his mission is one of the first things Jesus does at the beginning of his public life. He approaches some young fishermen and invites them to follow him, to become fishers of men. And this tells us something important. The Lord loves to involve us in his work of salvation. He wants us to be active with him, responsible and protagonist. A Christian who is not active, who is not responsible in the work of the announcing of the gospel of the Lord, who is not a protagonist of his faith, is not a Christian. As my grandmother used to say, is a Christian in red water, lukewarm. The Lord would not need this in itself, but he does so despite the fact that it involves taking on many of our limitations. Look, for an example, at how much patience he had with the disciples. Often they did not understand his words. At times they do not agree among themselves. For a long time, they are unable to accept some essential aspects of his preaching, such as service. And yet Jesus chose them and continued to believe in them. This is important. The Lord chose us to be Christians. We are sinners. We do one sin after the other, but the Lord continues to believe in us. To believe in us. This is something beautiful. The Lord is really marvelous. Indeed, bringing God's salvation to everyone was for Jesus the greatest joy, his mission, his food, the meaning of his existence among us. And in every word and deed with which we join with him in the beautiful adventure of giving love, light and joy multiply, not only around us, but also in us. And in this way, we become fully what we are made for. To proclaim the gospel then is not wasted time. It is being happier, helping others to be happy. It is to free ourselves by helping others to be free. It is becoming better by helping others to be better. Dear brothers and sisters, let us ask ourselves then, do I pause every now and then to remember the joy that grew in me and around me when I welcomed the calling to know and bear witness to Jesus? And when I pray, do I thank the Lord for having called me to make others happy? Finally, do I wish to make someone savor through my testimony and my joy how beautiful it is to love Jesus? May the Virgin Mary help us to taste the joy of the gospel.
Ave Maria, gracia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tui mulieribus, et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Iesus.
Santa Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostre. Amen.
Ecce ancilla Domini.
Fiat mi secundum verbum tuum.
Ave Maria, gracia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tui mulieribus, et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Iesus.
Santa Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostre. Amen.
Et verbum caro factum est.
Et habitavit in nobis.
Ave Maria, gratia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tui mulieribus, et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Iesus.
Santa Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostre. Amen.
Ora pro nobis, Santa Dei Gentris.
Udine ficiamur promissionibus Christi.
Grazie a Tua, in questo Domine, mentibus nostris infunde, ti angelo annunziante, Christi Fili Tui, incarnazione coniovim, per passione meius ad crucem, a resurrezione gloria perducamur, per Christum Dominum nostrum.
Amen.
Gloria Patri et Filio et Spiritui Sancto.
Sicut erat in principio et nunc et semper, et in saecula saeculorum. Amen.
Pro fidelibus defuntis, regim aeterna Donei Domine,
et lux perpetua lucet Deis,
requiescant in pace.
Amen.
Sit nomen Domini benedictum,
ex hoc et usque in saeculum,
aiutorium nostrum in nomine Domini,
qui feci caelum et terram.
Benedicat vos, Omnipotens Deus, Pater, Filii, et Spiritus Sancti. Amen. Amen. Cari fratelli e sorelle,
dear brothers and sisters, the next months will lead us to the opening of the Holy Door, which will mark the beginning of the Jubilee. I invite you to intensify prayer, your prayers, to prepare ourselves to live this event of grace so that we can experience the force of the interior hope. Therefore, we begin from today the year of prayer. It's a whole year dedicated at discovering the value, an absolute value and need of prayer. Prayer in personal life, in the life of the church, prayer in the world. We will be helped by the dicastery of evangelization will help us throughout this year. We pray this week for the unity of Christians. Let us not stop to continue to pray for peace in Ukraine, in Israel, in Palestine, and in many other parts of the world. It's always the weak and the poor who continue to suffer the results of this war. I think of children killed and injured by the effects of the war, and their dreams and hopes are destroyed. We feel the responsibility to pray so that we can build peace for these suffering people. I have learned with pain and sadness the events in Haiti where sisters have been abducted. I pray that these hostages, these sisters, will be released. And I invite everyone to continue to pray that violence will stop, because it continues to provoke so much violence, especially to that dear population of Haiti. I greet all of you who have come here from Rome, from Italy, and from different parts of the world. In a particular way, I greet the pilgrims from Poland, from Albania, from Colombia, students of the Institute Pedro Marcellis and University of America, who are studying in Florence, group from Panama, and priests and from Ecuador. And I assure you all for peace, especially in Ecuador. I assure you of my prayers for peace in your country. People from Fiducia in Perugia, and the teachers of Union Cattolica, and the group Scout from Calvi. I wish you all a blessed Sunday.
Non dimenticatevi di pregare per me. Buon pranzo e arrivederci.
So I wish you all a happy Sunday, and please don't forget to pray for me. Buon pranzo e arrivederci. And here we join this enthusiastic crowd, and the Pope has just addressed those beautiful words to us, but also he has shared his concerns with us, especially for peace, prayer for peace. And also he made an announcement that is, from today we begin a year of prayer, which will lead us for the next few months to the opening of the Holy Door for the Jubilee. And he has invited us then to pray personally, but for the church and for the world. And then he shared his concerns about the sisters that were abducted and kidnapped in Haiti. And he's inviting us to pray for peace in that country, that there is a lot of violence. And then, of course, we continue to pray for all those countries that have war. And he mentioned them: Israel, Palestine, Ukraine, and in a special way for the children that are affected and suffer because of these war and violence. And that then brings to the close this live broadcast of the Angelus. My name is Bonga Majola. It's been a great pleasure and joy to be offering and this live broadcast and translation, English translation. This ends the live broadcast of the recitation of the noonday Angelus with Pope Francis here at St. Peter's Square on the third Sunday in ordinary time. I invite you to please visit the Vatican News web portal, Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, and YouTube accounts for coverage of today's Angelus and other Vatican and world news. We will be back again on Wednesday for the official, for the audience, the public, the papal audience on Wednesday. On behalf of Vatican Media, I would like to thank you and thank our in-studio audio technicians and our audio coordinator and all of our media partners, TV and radio, and our friends who have made this broadcast possible. And thank you for joining us. Blessed Sunday to you all. Arrivederci e buona domenica. Praised be Jesus Christ. Laudetur Jesus Christus.